We will be discussing today polycystic ovary syndrome or disorder. In short, what we say PCOS or PCOD. It's a female's problem which leads to irregular menstrual cycles and problem in conceiving. We'll be discussing a few solutions for that. The two main solutions are exercise and second one is diet. One needs to exercise on the regular basis and diet is also very important for that. Generally, what happens in the modern time, people eat too much outside, takes too much of junk food. One should avoid taking junk food or white flour. That is what we say, maida. In India itself, it is said that around 10 million females are suffering from PCOS or PCOD. You can calculate that what the number would be in the whole world. The solution is exercise, diet, avoiding the junk food, and aerated drinks also. We'll be doing a few exercises today, a few pranayams that will help you to come out of this problem. Let's start. Let me introduce you. Today, our trainer, Meenakshi Singh. She'll be helping me doing the workout for PCOS and PCOD. Let's start the session. Let's start with the first exercise, that is butterfly. Let's go for it. Join your feet together. Make sure the back is straight. Interlock the fingers, hold your feet. Make sure the back is straight, move your knees down and up. You don't need to worry if your knees are touching down or not, just you need to move it bigger. Butterfly, direct hit. Hits at your pelvic area. Keep going. Make sure the back is straight. Keep going. Superb exercise to open up the pelvic area. Let's take the feet a little forward. Let's hold you both knees with your hands. Raise the knees up together, join the knees up, press them down, up again, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Let's do it 10 to 20 times. Relax. Let's do rock the baby now. Shishupalasana. Let's hold your left foot. Keep the right knee also bending in. Let's move the leg. Push the knee forward. This way. Pushing the knee forward, pulling the foot in. Keep moving. Move bigger, left and right. Good way to open the hip girdle. Push your pelvis. You can do it 15 to 30 times. Relax. Change the side now. Let's go other side. Keep moving bigger. Make sure the back is straight. Relax. Let's open your legs wider. Let's do the Chakki Chalasana. Make sure the legs are straight. Point the toes upside. Let's interlock the fingers. Let's start from right to left. Take the hands out, outside the feet, and roll it back. Outside the foot, come back side. Keep your hands straight. Keep reaching out. Make big circles. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Legs absolutely straight. Not bending the knees. You can do it 10 to 30 times as per your capacity. Last one, relax, easy. Let's go other side. Left to right now, push it out. Once more, relax, easy, keep your back straight, toes facing up, inhale, raise both hands up, let's do Bhunamanasana, take the hands forward, down on the ground, slowly pushing the hands forward, 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 take your time, go, so comfortably you're able to reach, go forward, 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 and try touching your head down on the ground. There is no problem if you're not able to touch the head on the ground, but if you touch it, that would be very good. Keep holding. Look forward, inhale the hands up, relax, easy, take your legs in front, take your hands beside the body and bump your thighs. Take your legs in, cross legs, sit comfortable. Let's lie down on the back for the next exercise. Lying on the back. You need to raise your both legs straight up. Point the toes up. Then open your legs wider. Then go cross with the legs. Out. Then crease. Crease and cross. Crease and cross. Make sure your lower back is stretching down. The knees are straight and locked. Keep going. Breathing is normal. Two, one, and last. Bend your legs, slowly come down, easy. Let's turn on the stomach. The next asana we're going to do is Shalabhasana.
Take your stomach down, place both palms under the thighs, palms facing up, feet together and flat. Now inhale to raise your both legs up together. Keep holding. Shalabhasana or the locust pose not only strengthens your back, but it stimulates the pelvic area also, ensuring the right kind of stimulation and health for your reproductive organs. Stay up for some time, breathing is normal. Keep holding. Keep looking forward, keep pushing the chin forward, knees are absolutely straight. Breathe. Slowly come down. easy. Relax for a while. Let's do Dhanurasana now. Bending your both legs in, holding the ankles from outside, keeping the knees separate from each other. Inhale to raise your both legs up, raise your head and chest high. Pressing the belly down. Keep looking up. Breathing is normal, light. Keep looking up. Keep pushing the legs upwards. Good exercise to keep the cyst in the ovaries or uterus away from your life. Slowly come down. Relax. Relax for a while. Gently taking the left knee out to the side. Face also to the left. Relax for some time. Stay at ease. Relax. Easy.
Next exercise, let's come in the plank pose. Make your legs straight, palms under the shoulders, curl your toes in. Slowly go up in the plank. Make sure the shoulders are above the palms. Raise the left leg a little up. Take the knee forward to the chest. Exhaling, inhale back, slow. Exhale forward, inhale back. Forward, back, forward, back. Keep going. Last one, little slow. Other side, right leg up, knee forward, back, keep going. Last one, come down. Easy. Breathe. Nice turn on your back. The next exercise we'll be doing is Sarvangasana. Bend your legs into the chest. Raise the legs straight up. And slowly pressing elbows or palms down, raise your back. Raise, go high up. Bending straight on the shoulders. Relax your feet. Relax the face. Close your eyes for some time. You should be holding it for 30 seconds to 2 minutes maybe. Sarvangasana has multiple benefits, especially very good for hormonal balance. Let's hold another 10 seconds. Gently bend your legs. Drop your back down first. Drop your legs also down. Relax. Relax for a while. Let's do the fish pose, Matsyasana. Make Padmasana or the lotus pose in lying down position. Pressing elbows down, gently raise your upper back and shoulders. Take the top of the head down and hold your big toes with your hands. Setting elbows down on the ground. Keep pushing the chin back. Keep holding. Breathe normal. Gently release the head. Release the legs also. Take your legs straight. Gently turn to the side. Using your hands. Slowly sit straight up. Sit in a comfortable posture. Preferably Padmasana. If you're not able to do the Padmasana, you may sit in any posture. Choose a Hasta Mudra. Dhyan Mudra would be good. Joining your index fingers with the thumb tips. Wrists gently place on the knees, back straight. Close your eyes for some time and breathe deeper. We'll be doing some pranayams that are very good for PCOD. Breathing is deep, head and face relaxed. Let's do Kapalabhati Kriya now. We do active exhalations in that and inhalations are passive. So, and we need to contract the abdomen in every time we exhale. Exhaling through the nostrils, keeping the head and face relaxed throughout. Inhale to full capacity. Exhale out. Keep exhaling. Keep your eyes gently closed. Keep a smile on your face. Keep exhaling, contracting the abdomen in every time. Keep going. You may do it for a minute and slowly, gradually start raising the time from 1 minute. You can take it up to 15 minutes. And as and when you feel uneasy, you may take a break, breathe normal 2-3 times, then start again. Contracting the abdomen in every time stimulates the ovaries, uterus, and the fallopian tubes. Very good for polycystic ovary disorder or syndrome. Keep exhaling. Relax, back is straight, eyes are closed, relax the head, forehead, shoulders and the spinal cord, keep the focus within, breathe normal, breathe light. Deep inhale, exhale out. Let's do Brahmari Pranayama. We'll do it 5 times, but you can do it 5 to 20 times, slowly, gradually increasing it. Let's block your eyes with the middle fingers. Index fingers has to be placed above the eyebrows. Keep your tongue in the air or fold it upside to the soft palate. Inhale full, generate the humming sound. Let's do it 5 times. Blocking the ears, inhale and go. ध्यान मुद्रा, keep your eyes closed, focus within, feeling the effect of vibrations, especially the back side of the head where hypothalamus is located. Hypothalamus stimulates the pituitary gland, which is responsible for all the hormonal and chemical balance. Hormonal balance is the main reason for PCOD or PCOS. Stay relaxed. Gently open your eyes with blinking. Believe you me, guys, these exercises are really effective. I've seen ladies to come out from this problem within 6 months to 1 year. I've seen females who were not able to conceive from 5 years to 13 years after their marriage. And they have a happy family now, they have kids, and this problem does not exist in their life. So be patient with yoga. It takes some time, but you'll definitely come out of it. I wish you all the best. Thank you so much.